Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. There have been some questions about what is the best time to buy. Is it the 52 week high or is it the 52 week low? And this is going to be a representation of the same. So let's look at some of the charts. What I have done here is I have plotted two lines, two gray lines. One is the 52 week high and the other one is the 52 week low. And then whenever it breaks the 52 week high, I mark that with a green sign saying a buy. Whenever it breaks the 52 week low, I'm marking that with red sign sell. And this is because this is how I believe is the right way of doing it. Let's test it. Let's check what happens. So here, because I don't have any data beyond that, so probably these whipsaws skip those. So here on 14/9/2006 around PNB, I've just chosen a stock. It broke the 52 week high. Are you going to be selling if you had owned this? Probably it's not a good decision because it is going up. Then here in 2008 June, it broke the 52 week low. Are you going to be buying? Probably not a good thing because it has gone even down. People say, okay, fine, you buy there some, and then one more time you buy some more, and then look at the rise that it gave. But then what I defend saying I would rather wait till the May of 2009. So from June of 2008 to 2009 May, it has not done anything. I have got little bad entry, but then look at the rise. So one full year you did not get anything, and you had to test your patience rather than that get in after a year time and then look at the rise. Next, I mean, same argument people do, it holds, does hold true here. September of 2011 hit new 52 week low. If you would have bought something here, then again bought something here, again bought something here, how many times do you have capability to buy, keep buying? From the levels of 184, it went all the way down to 82. Your 10 lakhs would have become 5 lakhs. Do you have capacity to hold on? I'm not sure. I don't have. I'm not one of those guys. So let's look at something else. I'm just going to select things random. So this is Reliance Capital. Same thing. Here, when it hit the 52-week low, I would probably not buy. But when it crack the 52 week high, if I buy, look at the rise. When it broke the 52 week low for the first time, I would probably sell. I would have sold even earlier than that using some of my other principles, supply demands. But anyways, here if you really look at the look at buying, there's another break, so many breaks, and then eventually this stock has not done anything. Not for 1 year, not for 2 years, from 2008 all the way till 2017, 10 years, it has not been able to cross those levels. Even here, some point in time, it crossed the 52 week high, but then again, it has gone only sideways. This is not a chart that I would bet myself on. Let's talk about Reliance. People say Reliance has not done anything. So somewhere here it would have broken that 52 week high and gave very nice rally, probably a time to sell somewhere, and then it only kept on going within the circle. And first time it gave buy was somewhere here, that is 2013 Jan. You might have bought it, but then there was a sell, sideways rally, nothing much doing, and then there was another buy which came sometime around 2015 July. That was at 1033. Today the stock is at 1600. Now if you want to buy the 52 week high breaking, that is the right thing to do. That's how it looks like. Let's look at NTPC, the same story. Here somewhere it broke the first time the 52 week high, gave good rally, and then again here buy sideways. Yes, it did not make you money, but then you are not really going to be putting in and waiting all the way. It has gone sideways, it has not gone down. Then when it hit 52 week low, this is not the time to buy, this is the time to sell, get out, and then this is the time to buy. It goes up. Whenever a particular stock breaks 52 week high, it goes up. Whenever it breaks 52 week low, most likely it goes down. There's nothing right and wrong in the stock market. Remember, I need to talk about the risk disclosure. You've seen this multiple times, but again, this talk about the market analysis, everything is me for me. It's only for learning purposes for you. If you want to do anything, please evaluate your own risk. It's your own money, your own hard-earned money. So let's look at some of my favorites. Some things which I've shown you, very good. Arvind is one of my favorites. I've been tracking this for a very, very long time. It hit the 52 week high somewhere here, did not give very nice. When it broke that level, you could get out, but then even then there's not much of a follow through. Again, hit 52 week high here, 40 rupees, went all the way to 111 rupees. Then again it broke the 52 week high here, 107 rupees, and today the stock is at 370. Three times from 2013 till 2017. Can you expect anything more from anyone, any of these stocks? Let me look at another favorite. Maybe iShare is a good one. See, look at this. It broke somewhere here, the high, and then only one-sided. From price of 580, it has gone to 28,000. Look at the growth. Look at the flow. So the only point that I'm trying to make here is, do not go for anything which is cracking down. Maruti, another very nice bet. From here, when it broke 1352, just kept on going one way high. Again, one more time, break 4746, again going back, double. It has almost doubled from 08 2016, less than 1 year it has doubled. Here 2012 it was 1329, all the way till 4700, almost three times. So these are, you have got so many of these. You have got stocks which are going up and up and only up. And if you cannot skip these, you really, really cannot have this, have anything. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked it, please like it. Please share it. Have a great day. Bye.